viewers, welcome back to our channel Dirgha Jeevithyam. Today's video is all about sleep. In Ayurveda, Nidra is the term used to refer sleep. Sleep is one among the three pillars of life. The other two are Ahara and Brahmacharya. Let's get started. Physiology of sleep. When the mind as well as the soul gets exhausted or becomes inactive and the sensory and motor organs becomes inactive, then the individual gets sleep. Sleep is nothing but the location of the mind in a place unconnected with the sensory and the motor organs. In the event of exhaustion of the mind, the individual also gets exhausted because action of individual is dependent on that of the mind. So, when mind disassociates itself from the object, individuals also disassociate themselves from their object. The sensory and the motor organs are not active because of the inaction of the individuals. Sleep is of 7 types. Mental and physical exertion brings about inactivity of the mind, resulting in disassociation of the mind and the sense organ from their object, which is responsible for sleep. But if there is excessive exertion, this may cause vishesha of vata, leading to sleeplessness. Thus, even though exertion is a causative factor for sleep, excessive exertion is responsible for aggravation of the vata, which causes sleeplessness. By nature, night serves as a causative factor for sleep. Sound and timely sleep gives us happiness, nourishment, strength, virility, knowledge and long healthy life. Improper sleep leads to sorrow, emaciation, weakness, sterility, ignorance and even death. Like the night of destructions, untimely and excessive sleep and prolonged vigil takes away both longevity and happiness. Insomnia is caused by elimination of doshas from body and head through purgation and emesis, raktam mokshanam, suppression of tamas and predominance of sattva guna. The above mentioned factors along with overwork, old age, disease especially due to vata disorder like colic pain are known to cause sleeplessness even in normal individual. Some are insomnic even by nature. Effect of night awaking. Vigil during night causes roughness in the body. Sleep during daytime causes unctuousness. And dozing and sitting posture does neither cause roughness nor unctuousness. Indication of day sleep. In summer season, night becomes shorter and vata gets aggravated in the body due to absorption of fluid. Therefore, we can sleep during the summer season. Those exhausted by singing attain the normal health due to nourishment of dhatus by sleep during daytime. Sleep during daytime is especially useful for those suffering from diarrhea. Those suffering from indigestion get rid of the aliments if they sleep during the daytime because sleep enhances digestive power by upsetting the passage of heat out of the body, resulting in quick digestion of the food. Those who are accustomed to sleep during daytime should not give up this habit all of a sudden as it might lead to consequence. Those who remain awake during the night should also sleep in the daytime in order to alleviate the vata caused by the vigil. There are some contraindications regarding the day sleep. If one violates a prescription regarding sleep during daytime, he would subject himself to various other disorders. So, one should keep in view the merits and demerits of sleep in various seasons and situations in order that it may bring happiness to him. Persons suffering from untimely sleep should undergo fasting, emesis, sudation and asyam. In case of excessive sleep, person can go for emesis, nasal drops, fasting and collyrium. Loss of sleep results in: if one does not sleep properly in the night, he should make it up by sleeping during the daytime for half the period spent in the night vigil. Methods and measures to induce a good sleep. Here ends my video regarding sleep. Thanks for watching.